As we did for other lessons, before starting this lesson on requirements engineering, I want to ask a world expert on this topic a few questions.
I'm here with Jane Cleland-Huang, a professor at DePaul University, and Jane is a world expert in the area of requirements engineering, which is the theme of this lesson. So I'm talking to Jane, who's currently in Chicago, and I want to ask her a few questions about requirements engineering. So hi, Jane. How are you?
Fine, thank you, Alex.
And thank you so much for agreeing to be interviewed for our course. I'm sure the students will really benefit from this. And let me start with the first question, which is, what are software requirements?
That's an interesting question. And software requirements basically provide us a description of what a system has to do. So typically they describe the functionality or the features that the system has to deliver in order to satisfy its stakeholders. And we usually talk about the requirement specification in terms of what the system's going to do, and we describe it sometimes formally in terms of a set of shell statements, so the system shall do this or shall do that, or we can use various templates to specify those textual requirements. But requirements can also be represented informally in the form of user stories or use cases, or more formally in the form of state transition diagrams and even in kind of formal specifications, especially for critical parts of safety critical systems.
And now that you discussed what the requirements are, what is requirements engineering?
So that's also an interesting question, because if you notice the term engineering, and I'm sure in the other parts of the software engineering process that you're discussing in your course, parts such as testing or coding, they don't have the word engineering there. And I think one of the reasons requirements engineering has that term is because it covers a number of different activities. So it includes things such as working with stakeholders to elicit or to proactively discover what their requirements for the system are, analyzing those requirements so that we understand the trade-offs. So you might have different stakeholders that care about different things, and it might not be possible to deliver all of those things. So we have to analyze the feasibility of the requirements, explore the trade-offs, emerge conflicts. And then, of course, the specification part, which we talked about a little bit already, and the validation. So did we, in fact, get the requirements right? Did we build a system that actually matches our requirements? And then on into the requirements management process. And the requirements management process kind of like goes through things like change management. So what if our customer, our stakeholders need the system to change? How do we manage changing requirements? And I think this is one of the reasons that we've coined the term engineering, because it has to be a systematic process which extends across the whole of the system lifecycle.
And I guess my last question here is, so now that we heard about software requirements and about software requirements engineering, why is requirements engineering so important? So what happens if we don't do it right?
Well, I'm sure that, you know, many people have probably read the kind of reports like the Standish report and other reports of failed projects and things like that, and are aware that one of the major reasons for projects failing is because we didn't get the requirements right in the first place. So if we don't understand the requirements, then we're simply going to build the wrong system. Getting requirements right includes all sorts of things, such as finding the right group of stakeholders so we don't exclude major groups of stakeholders, understanding the requirements correctly. There have been many, many different examples of projects that have failed. For example, in America, the healthcare.gov failure. And while we cannot put the blame squarely in the area of requirements, because obviously the project was challenged for a number of different reasons, but clearly it underperformed in many respects related to security and performance and reliability. And these are all parts of the requirements process, things that should have been discovered, and the system should have been built in order to meet those requirements. Getting the requirements right in the first place puts us a project on the right foot, and so that gives us a much better chance of delivering to the customer what they need and designing a solution that really meets those requirements. So it's a critical part of the overall software engineering process.
Okay, so that's critical, and we better get our requirements right. That's the message.
Yeah.
Okay, well, thank you so much, Jane, for taking the time off your busy schedule to speak with us. I'm sure the students really appreciate this, and we'll talk to you soon.
Bye, Alex. Thank you.
Bye, Jane. Bye-bye.
Jane gave us an interesting perspective on requirements engineering and its importance. Let's now start our lesson with a general definition of requirements engineering.